I'm Chris Edwards and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. We're going with our second week in a row of playtester picks. So first up, we're going to check in with Michelle and see what she's rocking out on the courts.
Thanks, Chris. I have been testing a ton of fun strings in my racket of choice, my RF97. And most recently, I started playtesting the Ashaway Crossfire ZX, which is a hybrid that features Kevlar mains, which if you know anything about Kevlar, it's gonna be super durable as well as spin friendly. And then Monogut ZX Pro is in the crosses, which is a very soft material. I'm loving the playability from this. It really pockets the ball. It's been super fun. J-Dub and I just recorded a podcast with Steve from Ashaway, so stay tuned for that. We get into a deep dive in this string and many others from Ashaway, so it's been really fun to try something different out there. And then my second product today is the brand new Babolat Pure Drive. We have these available for demo right now, so this is the first time you guys can play test this racket alongside of us. We've been play testing it a bunch. If you like the Pure Drive, get it in your hands. Tons of power, lots of spin, good access to all things from the court, really fun to play offensive with. And something we've noticed is a lot of players that previously didn't love the Pure Drive are really enjoying this. So I really encourage you to demo the Pure Drive and get it in your hands. It's super fun. You're gonna have an awesome time on the court with it. Now let's go see what Troy's rocking.
For my picks today, a shoe we just recently reviewed, the Air Zoom GP Turbo from Nike. Comfort's a big thing for me when I pick out a pair of court shoes, and it really doesn't get much better than these. It's just a super plush shoe. Underfoot, it's got that full Air Zoom unit, and compared to the Zoom Zero that it replaces, your foot's even closer to that airbag, so you just really feel that plush ride. And then the upper of the shoe, compared to the Zoom Zero, just much softer, much easier to get your foot in the shoe, and it's just really comfortable around the toes. Everything about this shoe just screams comfort to me. And then this particular shoe color right here also screams out retro vibes from Nike. This is their Challenge Court collection, so Tiafo and some of the Nike players will be using this at the US Open, and just love the retro look here, inspired by some of Andre Agassi's old shoes, the Tech Challenges. So just really loving the comfort of this shoe, also the style of this particular model, just enjoying it a lot. And then as far as a racket goes, brand new addition to the Yonex E-Zone line, the 98 Tour. I really just like the weight of this racket. It's 315 grams unstrung, right about a 330 swing weight. So there's really not much need for customization here. I might even just put a leather grip on it like I tend to do with most of my frames. But I love the feel of this racket, super solid, stable in stock form. And they also lowered the stiffness on this one just slightly compared to the 305 version. So I'm getting a little bit more plush ride, a little more responsive feel, just a great addition to the line.
All right, leave it to the old guy to be the closer here. I just want to bring attention and a little more focus to two items that I'm really digging on in terms of comfort and performance. And one would be another great addition to the 305 gram frame weight and 98 head size kind of collection of frames, and that's the new Dunlop FX 500 Tour. This racket, you know, like a lot of the 305s, they seem to kind of juice them up and have a higher swing weight, keep them real stable. This one's a little more maneuverable. It's got a swing weight that's a little under 320 with a 6-point tip light balance. So for me, it really rode the fine line between stability and maneuverability very nicely. It's got a very evenly spaced 16-19 pattern, even towards the sweet spot. So you get a great grip on the ball, very predictable trajectory. This from any spot of the court was just top notch for me all the way around, and I just want to shine a little more attention to that. And along with that, talking about comfort and performance, one of my favorite rides out of here would be the K-Swiss Hypercourt Supreme. This shoe, you know, a lot of shoes, you've got three traits to work with, that being lightweight, durability, or comfort. I think it's a challenge for a lot of shoe manufacturers to kind of hit on all three. This one does a really good job at kind of giving you the three traits all together in one shoe. And if you do have a slightly wider foot type, it's going to fit even better. For a shoe that does not include a sole warranty, I would say it's very durable in that way. Overall, just a great ride under and over foot.
Thanks, Booty. I'm going to take you through a couple of products as well this week, and it's been super hot here in California. So I've been rocking the Yonex Dry Grap on my rackets. Absorbs the sweat really well, and I can keep solid grip on the racket. And you know, it's important to replace your overgrip often, especially in hot, humid conditions, and really lets you just relax the hand, and you can play with a more fluid stroke. So definitely enjoying that out there. And then also to stop my grip from getting super soaked and sweaty. I've been rocking a lot of sweatbands recently, and the ones I've really fallen in love with are these retro-inspired feeler ones. And you can get the Borg-inspired ones if you want to go true feeler heritage, but I like this double-wide fit because it gives you a lot of room to wipe your brow down, also stops the sweat going down my arms and keeps my handles nice and dry. So got a great selection of feeler sweatbands and also other brands, so be sure to check our website for more on those. And that's all we got for this week. Thank you so much for watching.